subscribe Tag TV YouTube channel and press the notification button.
Good evening. Welcome to South Asia Newsline. I'm Yeshi Chonzong. Here are the top stories we are tracking for you on Wednesday, the 1st of December. India imposes new rules for international flyers amid Omicron scare. Widespread demolition move in Pakistan's Karachi, a scheme to make it China's town, says Altaf Hussain. And Maldives ex-president Yamin walks free after graft conviction overturned. And now for all the details. International airports across India on Wednesday launched mandatory COVID-19 tests for flyers as part of fresh guidelines amid the threat from the new Omicron variant. The country's aviation regulator said it would announce the resumption of scheduled commercial international flights in due course instead of a planned restart on December 15. Currently, only special flights as per bilateral or other agreements are flying.
International airports across India on Wednesday imposed new restrictions in the wake of the government's fresh guidelines for international passengers amid the threat from the new Omicron COVID-19 variant. As per the guidelines, all passengers coming from at-risk countries have to undergo mandatory RT-PCR test, and 5% of passengers arriving from elsewhere would also have to take the test on a random basis. The passengers will have to wait for the results before leaving the airport or taking a connecting flight. Meanwhile, the country's aviation regulator in a notice said that it would announce the resumption of scheduled commercial international flights in due course instead of a planned restart on December 15. Currently, only special flights as per bilateral or other agreements are flying.
No, not available. It's crazy and difficult, and for what, I don't know. For why they do this, I don't know.
And what is the situation in Ukraine from this new variant violet?
In Ukraine, you need to wait 15 minutes for test and can go.
Though India has not reported any Omicron case so far, Health Ministry said that authorities are taking utmost precaution and several states have been asked to ramp up testing. After battling a record jump in infections and deaths in April and May, cases have come down substantially in India. As of Wednesday, active cases in the country stood at 99,023.
Security forces on Wednesday neutralized two terrorists, including a top commander of Pakistan-based Jaish-e-Mohammed, in an encounter in Pulwama district of India's Jammu and Kashmir. A senior police official said both of them were involved in several terror crimes in the Union Territory.
Two terrorists were neutralized in an encounter with security forces in Pulwama district of India's Jammu and Kashmir on Wednesday. The gun battle broke out in the early hours of Wednesday in Kasba area of Pulwama. Inspector General of Jammu and Kashmir Police Vijay Kumar informed the slain terrorists included Yasin Pare, a top commander of Pakistan-based Jaish-e-Mohammed or JEM terror group, and a foreign terrorist identified as Furqan. Pare was an IED expert, and both of them were allegedly involved in several terror crimes in the Union Territory, the official said. The terror-related incidents, including civilian killings, have seen a significant surge in the Kashmir Valley in the past few months. As many as 133 terrorists, including many top commanders, have also been neutralized this year in the region, Jammu and Kashmir police said last month.
Moving on, Altaf Hussain, the founder leader of Mutahida Qaumi Movement, has blamed the properties of Mohajis in Pakistan's Karachi are being demolished to make room for China to convert the city into a satellite colony and accommodate the Chinese. He termed the move an economic carnage of Mohajis, a community of immigrants who left India during 1947 partition and settled in Pakistan.
Altaf Hussain, the founder leader of Mutahida Qaumi Movement or MQM, has said that properties of Muhajirs in Pakistan's Karachi are being demolished to make room for China to convert the city into a remote satellite colony and accommodate China in the region. He strongly condemned the Supreme Court's recent orders for the demolition of the Nasla Tower, a residential tower in Karachi, which houses a number of Muhajir families. He termed the move an economic carnage of Muhajirs. MQM has long blamed it has been well over 70 years, but Muhajirs, a community of Urdu-speaking immigrants who left India during partition in 1947 and settled mostly in Pakistan's Sindh, have still not been accepted worthy of equal rights and are subjected to discrimination and exploitation.
फौज के कहने पे कराची की बस्तियां तोड़ना शुरू कर दी ताकि चाइना के लिए वादा किया है कि हम आपको पूरा कराची क्लीन करके देंगे ताकि आप चाइना टाउन पूरे कराची में बना ले।
MQM, a mainstream Pakistani political party of the Muhajir community, also held a protest recently in the US against the ongoing demolition of houses and businesses of Muhajirs in Pakistan. The protesters demanded the right of self-determination under the UN charters and urged the international community to intervene.
A US delegation led by the Special Representative for Afghanistan, Thomas West, held talks with senior Afghan Taliban representatives in Qatar on Monday and Tuesday, the US State Department said. The two sides discussed the international community's response to the humanitarian crisis in Afghanistan, and the US delegation pledged to continue to support UN efforts to address the situation.
A U.S. delegation led by Special Representative for Afghanistan, Thomas West, expressed deep concerns over alleged human rights abuses in Afghanistan during its meeting with Taliban representatives in Qatar on Monday and Tuesday, the U.S. State Department said. In a statement, U.S. Department of State spokesperson Ned Price said, the two sides discussed the international community's response to the humanitarian crisis in Afghanistan, and the U.S. delegation pledged to continue to support UN efforts to address the situation. The U.S. officials expressed deep concern regarding allegations of human rights abuses and urged the Taliban to protect the rights of all Afghans, uphold and enforce its policy of general amnesty, and take additional steps to form an inclusive and representative government, the State Department said. The U.S. delegation urged the Taliban to implement a commitment on providing countrywide access to education at all levels for women and girls. The Taliban expressed openness to engaging with the international community on full access to education and welcomed efforts to verify and monitor progress to enroll women and girls in the school at all levels.
Nepal's main opposition, CPN-UML, overwhelmingly re-elected former Prime Minister KP Sharma Oli as the chairman of the country's largest communist party for the second time at the party's 10th General Convention held in Chitwan on Tuesday. Oli secured 1,840 votes while his nearest rival, Bhim Rawal, received just 223 votes in the election. Oli has made a comeback as the party chair for the next 5 years and has also managed to install leaders of his choice in all key offices, bearers, positions, thus consolidating his grip on the party. The UML Central Committee has 301 members. The revised party statute envisions 6 vice chairs, including Yuvraj Gyawali. All were proposed by Oli for the post. Ishwar Pokhrel and Shankar Pokhrel were elected senior vice chair and general secretary respectively, unopposed after Oli proposed them for the post. Oli's favourites Pradeep Gyawali, Prithvi Subha Gurung and Bishnu Rimmel were elected deputy general secretaries unopposed. As per the revised statute, the party has one senior vice chair, one general secretary and 3 deputy general secretaries. Maldives' former president Abdullah Yameen was freed from house arrest on Tuesday after a top court overturned a money laundering and embezzlement conviction, allowing him to potentially make a return to politics. Yameen was sentenced to 5 years in jail and fined $5 million in 2019 for embezzling $1 million in state funds, allegedly acquired through the lease of resort development rights and laundering the proceeds. Because of COVID-19, his jail term was shifted to house arrest. program. After an appeal by Yameen, a 3-member Supreme Court bench ruled on Tuesday there was insufficient evidence in the original case. Two previous appeals at lower courts had been rejected. The overturning of the verdict is a key moment in Maldives' often turbulent politics, as Yameen is now free to conduct political activities and even contest the next presidential election. Yameen, who served as Maldives' president from 2013 to 2018, is best known for drawing the country closer to China, invoking the ire of traditional ally India. He played a major role in ousting the archipelago's first democratically elected president, Mohamed Nasheed, who fled into exile before returning in 2018, when Yameen unexpectedly lost power in a national election. In a major development, Umla, a remote village in India's cold desert region of Ladakh, recently got tap water supply for the first time in each of its 25-odd households, even in sub-zero temperature. Villagers have expressed joy as it has now eased the prolonged water crisis in the region. Umla, a remote village in India's cold desert region of Ladakh, has become the 12th village in Leh district that has recently got tap water supply for the first time in each of its 25-odd households, even in sub-zero temperature. Expressing joy, locals said the water supply provided under the government's Jal Jeevan Mission has been life-changing for them, as they had to earlier struggle to get water, especially amid the winter season. In order to ensure the water does not freeze, the supply pipeline has been covered with an insulation jacket.
इस साल हम बहुत खुशी है, पानी सामने आ गया, नहीं तो पानी बंद हो जाता था सर, तो प्रॉब्लम था सर, बहुत दूर जाना पड़ता है, पहले तो नीचे बहुत नाले में जाना पड़ता है, अभी तो बहुत अच्छा लगता है, पानी तेरे आता है, ठंडी में भी पानी आ रहा है.
Jal Jeevan Mission was launched by Prime Minister Narendra Modi in August 2019. The scheme aims to connect every rural household in the country with a functional tap water connection by 2024. People across the world mark AIDS Day on December 1 to highlight the work done to eliminate the epidemic. In India, sex workers and social activists gathered and marked World AIDS Day by paying tribute and raising awareness related to its prevention and precautions on Wednesday. HIV continues to be a major global public health issue, having claimed 36.3 million lives so far. The virus attacks the body's immune system, and if not treated, it can lead to AIDS. The theme of World AIDS Day 2021 is End Inequalities and AIDS. On the occasion of World AIDS Day, sex workers and social activists in Eastern Siliguri district of West Bengal state made a symbolic red ribbon mural and lit candles in remembrance of those who have lost their lives due to HIV/AIDS. The acquired immunodeficiency syndrome, or AIDS, is a life-threatening disease caused by the human immunodeficiency virus HIV, in which a person's immune system becomes weak and redundant. AIDS is a later stage complication developed when a person suffers from HIV.
आज हम लोग वर्ल्ड एड्स डे का जो आज इवेंट जो इसीलिए हम लोग उसको मतलब एक ड्रॉ किए हैं रेड रिबन, उसी को हम लोग मोमबत्ती से सजाए हैं और उसी को ओपनिंग किए हैं कि ताकि जागरूकता रहे पूरा वर्ल्ड में, बहुत अच्छे से सब रहे, स्वस्थ रहे, एचआईवी से दूर रहे.
Awareness programs and rallies were also held across India on the occasion. In Rajkot city of Western Gujarat, more than 1,000 students made a human chain in the symbol of AIDS to create awareness. The red ribbon is the international symbol of HIV and AIDS awareness. In Vadodara city, an NGO organized street play to spread awareness on HIV/AIDS based on this year's theme, End Inequalities and AIDS. Internationally acclaimed Sen artist Sudarshan Patnaik also created a creative Sen art with the message, "Keep the promises," at Puri Beach on the occasion. According to a UN report, a total of 2.1 million people infected from HIV virus are estimated to be living in India in 2017.
Well, that's all we have for you from South Asia this evening.
Now our viewers can watch the show on SouthAsiaNewsline.com. You can also visit us on Facebook.com/AsiaNewsline and follow us on Twitter at AsiaNewsline. That's all in tonight's edition. We will see you same time tomorrow. Good night.
TAG TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.